I want to beat the other fellas to the street. I don't want no one should see. I ain't been walking so good.
Quicker, I've been... You know how many guys speak Olympus sympathy? Yeah, that bum leg of yours is a golden eye.
Someone gets the idea. I can't make it on my own, and they'll lock me up in the refuge for good. Be a pal, Jack. Help me down. Whoa!
Hey! You want to bust the other leg, too?
No, I want to go down.
You'll be down there soon enough. Take a moment. Drink in my penthouse. Die above the stinking streets in New York.
You're crazy.
Because I like the breath of fresh air. Because I like seeing the sky and the stars.
You're seeing stars, all right.
Them streets down there, they suck the life right out of my old man. Years of rotten jobs, stomped on by bosses. And when they finally broke him, they just tossed him to the curb like yesterday's paper. But they ain't doing that to me!
But everyone wants to come here.
Well, New York's fine for those who can afford a big, strong girl to lock it out. But I tell you, Crunchy, there is a whole other way out there. So you keep your small life in the big city. Give me a big life in a small town. They say folks is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away. To a little town, now fresh, that's spanking up. And well, I ain't never been there. I can see it clear as day. If you want, I bet you could see it through. Close your eyes, come with me. Where it's clean and green and pretty, and they went and made a city out of clay. By the minute that you get there, folks will walk right up and say, welcome home, son, welcome home to Santa Fe. Planting crops, splitting rails, swapping tails around the fire, set for Sunday when you lie around all day. Soon your friends are more like family, and they's begging you to stay. And that night, living sweet in Santa Fe.
You got folks there?
Got no folks nowhere. You?
I don't need folks. I got friends.
Hey, how about you come with me? You know, no one worries about no gimp leg in Santa Fe. You just hop a palomino and ride in style.
Feature me. Riding in style.
Hey, I bet if you want some clean air, you can toss that much for good.
Santa Fe, you can bet. We won't let them bastards beat us. We won't beg no one to treat us fair and square. There's a life that's worth the living, and I'm gonna do my share.
Burn the land, chase the sun,
swim the whole Rio Grande just for fun. Watch me stand, watch me run.
Don't you know that we's a family? And when I let you down, no way. Just hold on, kid, till that train makes Santa Fe.
From bottom. There's easy pickings guarantee.
Trying to thank our mom or father. They almost don't know salary.
It's a broken game we're playing. One will never lose. Long as sadness don't mind fading, just to get bad news. Ain't it a fine life? Carrying the banner through it all. A mighty fine life, carrying the banner tough and tall. When the bell rings, we go very vicious, Jesus Christ vicious. Sure beats washing dishes. What a fine life, carrying the banner home for you. We're always out there.
unfortunate day, you might find you got a bum game of your own. How'd you like us picking on you, huh? Maybe we should find out.
Wait till I get my hands on you!
Yeah, check your voice!
Trying to sell newspapers. We could use an exciting headline.
What have we got?
The trolley strike.
That's not exciting.
So,
it's boring. Folks want to know, is the trolley coming or am I walking? Nobody cares why.
And the strike's about to be settled. Governor Roosevelt just put his support behind the workers.
That man is a socialist.
Teddy Roosevelt is no socialist. He's an American hero.
The man wants to outlaw football for being too violent. Football, violent. You're right. He's no socialist. He's a commie.
Mr. Pulitzer, please, you must try to sit still.
People, you're making Nunzio nervous. And when Nunzio gets nervous, I don't look pretty.
You never liked Roosevelt. You wrote an editorial against him every day when he ran for governor. And guess what? He got elected.
How can I influence the voters if they're not reading my opinion?
Big photos attract readers.
You know how much big photos cost.
But without flashy photos and headlines, how are we supposed to sell more papers?
There's an answer right before your eyes. You're not thinking this through. Nunzio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here and then trim a bit there. Just a modest adjustment can fatten the bottom line.
Mr. Pulitzer, please.
Shaving is tricky, the razor should float. Shave me too close and you may cut my throat. It's the simplest solutions that bolster the bottom line.
But how does that help us sell more papers?
We don't sell papers, silly. Newsies sell papers.
I've got it. Right now, we charge the Newsies 50 cents for 100 papers.
Yes.
But if we raise the price to 60 cents per 100...
Now you're getting somewhere.
A mere tenth of a penny per paper.
Every single Newsie would have to sell 25 more papers just to earn the same amount of money.
My thought is that it's genius.
But it'll be awfully rough on those children.
Nonsense. I'll be giving them a real-life lesson in economics. I couldn't offer them a better lesson if they were my own. Give me a week and I'll train them to be like an army that's marching to war. Proud of themselves and so grateful to me, they'll be begging to pay even more. When there's dirt on your shoes, boys, for God's sake, relax. Why throw them out? All we need is some wax. Listen well to these barbershop lessons, for they'll see you through.
When you stop in the muck, you'll be fine. You'll erase any trace of decline.
Shine.
And the power of the press, yes, once again is mine. The price for the Newsies goes up in the morning. Just a few common sense hints, that's the bottom line.
Born to the breed!
This is so much better than school!
Think about it. When Pop goes back to work, we go back to school.
Alright, so how's about we divvy up the money, grab some chow, and then we find you somewhere safe to spend the night?
Oh, we gotta head home. Our folks are waiting with dinner.
You got folks, huh?
Doesn't everyone?
Our father tangled with a delivery truck on the job. It messed up his leg real bad, so that's how come we had to find work.
That makes sense. Too bad about your dad, though.
Why don't you come home with us for dinner? Our family would be happy to have you.
Mom's a great cook.
Thanks for that.
the invite, fellas, but I just remembered I got someone to meet, and they're probably waiting on me right now.
Is that who you're meeting? Kelly!
Run for it!
Officer, grab him! You, Jack Kelly, stop! Stop! Officer, he's there!
Come on! She locks up, the more the city pays her. Problem is, all the money goes straight into her own pocket. Do yourself a favor and see her play off her and the refuge.
Hey, you up there, shoot! No kids allowed in the theater!
Not even me, Miss Meta.
Jack Kelly, man of mystery, get yourself down here and give me a hug. Where you been keeping yourself, kid?
Oh, never far from yo, Miss Meta. Boys, may I present Miss Meta Larkin, greatest star on the Bowery today. She also owns the joint.
The only thing I own is the mortgage. Pleasure, gents.
Oh, pleasure.
What's the matter with you?
Blonde, she got no clothes on.
That's her costume.
I can see her legs. Set aside so she can get a better look. Theater is not only entertaining, it's educational. Got the picture, kid?
Miss Mel, I got a little situation out on the streets. Mind if I hide out here a while?
Where better to escape trouble than the theater? The Snyder after you again?
Hey, Jack, did you really escape jail in the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage?
What would the governor be doing at a place like a juvenile jail?
Well, so happens he was running for office at the time and wanted to show he cared for orphans and such, so while he got his mug in the paper, I got my butt in the back seat and off we rode to get.
Wow, you really know the governor?
He don't, but I do. Say, Jack, when you've got time, I want you to paint me some more of these backdrops. The last one you did is a doozy, and folks love it. And things have been going so well, I can actually pay.
I couldn't take your money, Miss Bill.
Wow, you pictured that?
Your friend is quite an artist.
Don't get overworked. It's a bunch of trees.
You're really good.
That boy's got natural aptitude.
Jeez, I never knew no one with an aptitude.
Miss Meta, you're on.
Yeah? How am I doing? Boys?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the star of our show, Miss Meta Larkin.
Oh!
Sunday? Think it's May?
Go away, I'm working.
Oh, working, girl, wow. Doing what?
Reviewing the show for the New York Sun.
Hey, I work for the Whale.
Somewhere out there, someone cares. Go tell them.
The view's better here.
Please go. I'm not in the habit of speaking to strangers.
Well, then you're gonna make a lousy reporter. The name's Jack Kelly.
Is that what it says on your rap sheet?
Oh, smart girl. Yeah, I admire smart girls. Beautiful, smart, independent.
Do you mind? You got it for free. At least pay attention.
Sorry, ma'am. I got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight's for suckers, at least it used to be. Look, girls are nice once or twice, till I find someone new. But I never planned on no one like you. Signs for suckers. At least see you.
Never told the truth about your dinner.
Thank you so much.
You act so bad for your wife.
What's going on?
You should have been here back in the
price, 60 cents per hundred.
What do you say?
That news?
It is to me.
They jack up the price of the bank.
I can eat 2 days on a dime.
Oh, I'll be sleeping on the street.
You already sleep on the street.
In a waste neighborhood.
Hey, what are you doing standing around here?
Hey, Jack, get a load of this.
My bullets are not making up already.
Cakes for the newsies.
Relax, it's gotta be a gag.
Line up!
Good job, Weasel. Really had the fellas going. I'll take 100 and be on my way.
100 will cost you 60.
I ain't paying no 60.
Then make way for someone who will.
You bet. Me and the fellas will take a hike over to the jungle.
Yeah!
Save the walk. They have their prices too.
Well, then we'll take our business to the sun.
Yeah! It's the same all over town. New day, new price.
Hey, why the jack-up?
Answers to questions like that, you gotta ask a little further up the food chain. So, you buying or you moving on?
Come here, fellas.
They can't just do that, can they?
Why not? It's their paper.
It's their world.
And we got no rights.
We got the right to start. Come on, let's get our papers and hit the streets while we still can.
At them prices?
We got a choice.
Hold on, no one's paying no new nothing.
You got an idea?
Keep your shirt on, let me think this through.
What's your angle?
Stop crowding him! Let the Jack's still thinking.
Sure he is. Can't you smell smoke?
All right. So here's the deal. If we don't sell papes, then no one sells papes. No one gets to that window till they put the price back where it belongs.
You mean like a strike?
You are, Davy. We're on strike.
Hold on. That's all right, man.
Shut down this place like them workers shut down the trolleys.
And then the cops will bust up our heads. Half them workers are laid up with broke bones.
Our cops ain't gonna care about a bunch of kids. Right, Davy?
Leave me out of this. I'm just trying to feed my family.
And the rest of us is on playtime? Just because we make pennies, don't give no one the right to rub our noses in it.
It doesn't matter. You can't strike. You're not a union.
Well, what advice has he is?
There's a lot that goes in order to being a union. Like membership.
What do you call these guys?
Hey. Hi.
And officers?
I nominate Jack President.
Gee, I'm touched.
What about a statement of purpose?
Oh, I must have left that in my other pants.
What's a statement of purpose?
Reason for forming the union.
Well, what reason did the Charlie Wiki say?
I don't know. Wages, work hours, safety on the job.
Well, we don't need that. But if your father had a union, you wouldn't be out here selling papes right now, okay?
Yeah.
So, our union is hereby formed to watch each other's backs. Union we stand.
Hey, that's not bad. Somebody write that down.
I got a pencil!
Hey, meet our Secretary of State.
Now what? If you want to strike, the union's gotta go.
So let's vote. What do you say, fellas? The choice is yours. Do we roll over, let Pulitzer pick our pockets? Or do we strike?
Strike!
You heard the voice of membership. The Newsies of Lower Manhattan are now officially on strike. What next?
Wouldn't a strike be more effective if someone in charge knew about it?
It'd be a pleasure to tell Weasel myself.
Yeah. And who tells Pulitzer? David.
I don't know. I guess I... You do, Mr. President.
That's right. We do. What do we tell them?
The newspapers gotta respect our rights as employees.
Pulitzer and Hearst gotta respect the rights of the working kids in this city.
They can't just change the rules when they feel like it.
That's right. We do the work, so we get a say.
So we've got a union!
Yeah!
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think we're nothing. Are we nothing?
No!
They gotta understand that we're not enslaved to them. We're free agents.
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think they got us. Do they got us?
No!
We're a union now. The Newsboy Union. And we mean business.
Even though we ain't got hats or badges, we're a union just by saying so. Just let him try!
Yeah.
No! We're all in this together. We can't beat up on other kids.
It's gonna take to stop the wagons. Are we ready?
Yeah!
Listen to me. What's it gonna take to stop the scabbers? Gambling the wet?
Yeah!
Well, then what we gotta do until we break the wheel of my evil and joy?
And the world will know! And enjoy know too!
Hearst and Pulitzer,
have
we got news for you?
See, the world don't know, but they're gonna pay.
Said hogging headlines, we'll be making them today.
And our ranks will grow.
Thank you.
tattoos.
And the things we do today will be tomorrow's news.
Yeah! And the die is cast, and the torch is passed, and the roar will rise.
On the streets and bars, and roar and
grow, and so your world will feel the fire and finally know.
Just busting out of the social pages. But if you give me the exclusive, I'll run with the story, and I promise I'll get you the space.
You really think we could be in the papers?
Shut down a paper like the world? You're gonna make the front page.
You want a story? Be in front of the circulation gates tomorrow morning, and you'll get one.
Oh, we bring a camera. You're gonna want to snap a picture of this.
Yeah!
All right, kids. Go play outside. I gotta set up for dinner. I got paying customers need to pay for.
Come on, we got newsies to visit.
Yeah, you won't be bugging us. We got a muffin to pay.
And the world will know. We can keep in score. Either they gives us our rights or we gives them a war. We've been down too long. And we pay our dues. And the things we do today will be tomorrow's news. And the die is cast. And the torch is passed. And the world will rise. And our ranks will grow. And so the world will feel the fire and finally know.
Les, we gotta head home. Bolts are waiting.
Stop the newsies from carrying out papers, but the wagons still deliver to the rest of the city. Tomorrow we stop the wagons.
Are you scared?
Do I look scared? But ask me again in the morning.
Good answer. Good night, Mr. Kelly.
Oh, come on! Where are you running? It ain't even supper time.
I'll see you in the morning. And off the record, good luck.
Hey, plumber. Write it good. We both got a lot riding on you.
You heard the man. Write it good. Write it good or it's back to wheezing your way through the old flower show. No pressure. Let's go. Newsies, stop the world. A little hyperbole never hurt anyone. With all eyes fixed on the trolley strike, there's another battle brewing in the city. Oh, if I could write about it. Come on, Catherine, those boys are counting on you. Oh, you poor boys. Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is big, lady, don't screw it up. This is not some little vaudeville I'm reviewing. Poor little kids versus rich, greedy, sour pusses. Huh? It's a cinch. It could practically write itself, and let's pray it does. As I may have mentioned, I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Well, that plus the screaming of 10 angry editors. A girl, it's a girl. How the hell is that even legal? Look, just go and get her. Not only that, there's a story behind the story. Thousands of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand, and there's someone to write about it. That's how things get better. Give life's little guys some ink, and when it dries, just watch what happens. Those kids will live and breathe right on the page, and once their center stage, you watch what happens. But who's there with her camera and
skirt chasing cock, you little son. Lie down with dogs and you wake up with a raise and a frog motion. So he's a flirt, a complete egomaniac. The fact is he's also the face of the strike. What a face of act. That's a face that can save us all from singing in the ocean. Like someone said, power tends to corrupt an absolute. Power weight corrupts absolutely. That's genius! But give me some time, I'll be twice as good as that. 6 months from never. Just look around at the world we're inheriting and think of the one we'll create. The mistake is they get old, that is not a mistake. But making us a real stay young forever. Give those kids and me the brand new century and watch what happens. It's David and Goliath, do or die, the fight is on, and I can't watch what happens. But all I know is nothing happens if you just give in. It can't be any worse than how it's been. And it just so happens that we just might win. So whatever happens, let's begin.
We got some bum information about a strike happening here today. Not that I'm complaining. My skull busting arm could use a day of rest.
Are we doing the right thing?
Of course we are. Maybe we could put this off a couple days.
No, we can't, Jack. Please say something. If we put this off any longer, they will never listen to us again.
We can't back down now. The modern Wudazo doesn't show. Like it or not, now is when we take a stand.
How's about we just don't show up for work? That'll send the message.
They'll just replace us. They need to see us stand our ground. Come on, Davey, tell them.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute. How you win it, we will find a way. But let us seize the day.
Hey Jack, look what I made. Good, huh? Strike!
That's great! That's pitiful.
Don't be so quick to judge. Maybe Colts will see that as window and feel sorry for us.
Specs, any center reinforcements?
Courage cannot erase our fear. Courage is when we face our fear. Tell those with power, safe in their tower, we will not obey. Behold the brave battalion that stand side by side, too few in number and too proud to hide. Then say to the others who did not follow through, you're still our brothers and
we will fight for you. Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Once we've begun, if we stand as one, someday become somehow.
Get your pace.
You work it or trespass it. What's your pleasure?
Hey, who are they? Scraps, what do you think?
Make a waltz in here. Take our job.
We can handle it.
Yeah!
Oh, we are all in this together. Oh, we do not stand a chance at all. No matter who. Jack, say something. Tell us.
All right, I know. I hear you. Listen, fellas. I know somebody put you up to this. Probably paid you some extra money, too, yeah? Well, it ain't right. Polter thinks we're gutter rats with no respect for nothing, including each other. Is that who we are? We stab each other on the back, and yeah, that's who we are. But if we stand together, we change the whole game. And it ain't just about us. All across the city, there are boys and girls who want to be out playing or going to school, instead of slaving to support themselves and their folks. Ain't no crime to being poor. Not one of us complains that the work we do is hard. Fellas, all we ask is a square deal. For the sake of all the kids and every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in this town, I beg you, throw down your papers. And join the strike.
Begun, one for all and all for one.
kids learned a lesson.
Noises! Get on!
Three
drink up, kids. And don't say I didn't never give you nothing. And before you say that water is nothing, just ask a fish in the desert.
Why do old people talk?
To prove they still alive.
Good morning. Would you get a load of these glum mugs? Could these really be the same kids that made it on the front page of the New York Times?
What?
Let me see. Look at, once you look at, that's me.
Where's me?
Wait till my old man gets a load of this. I won't be last in line for the top tonight.
Front page, anyway, even dead.
You got us in the paper?
You got yourselves in the paper.
Newsy, stop the world. Now there's a headline even Elmer can sell.
So, what else you got?
Mine's the only story that ran. Pulitzer declared a blackout on strike news, so even I'm shut down now. I heard they arrested Crutchy. Did they get Jack too?
The Lexus ran his door. They took her on the lam. First sight of the car.
Jack, don't run from no fight.
Get down, shortstop. Just reporting the notes.
Nah, for jumping's Jack's sake, can we stow the curiosity long enough to drink in the moment? I'm famous! Are you stupid or what? You're famous. The world is your oyster. Your oyster. Your fancy clam with a pearl inside.
Oyster! How much does being famous pay?
You don't need money when you're famous. They give you whatever you want. Gratis.
Such as?
A pair of new shoes with matching laces.
A permanent box that the sheephead races.
A strawberry on rye with the sour pickle.
My personal
puts
on a
boy
pickle.
Look at me, I'm the king of New York. Suddenly, I'm respectable, staring right at your lousy waist stature. Tomorrow they may ride fish.
Oh, yeah, Jack. This is Crunchy, by the way. These your guards, they is rude. They say, jump, boy, jump, or you're screwed. But the food ain't so badly so far. Cause so far they ain't brought us no food. Ha, ha. I missed the rooftop. Sleeping right out in your bed, in your penthouse in the sky. There's a cool breeze blowing, even in July. Anyway, so guess what? There's this secret escape plan I've got. Tie sheet to the bed, toss the end out the window, climb down and take off like a shot. Maybe though, not tonight. I ain't slept and my legs still ain't right. Hey, but Pulitzer is going down. And then Jack, I was thinking we might just go, like you were saying, man, where it's clean and clean and pretty with no buildings in your way. And you's riding, following oars every day. Once that dream makes... Ugh, damn this place. I'll be fine. Good as new. But there's one thing I need you to do. On the rooftop you said that the family looks out for each other. So you tell all the fellas from me to protect one another. The end. Your friend. Your best friend. Your brother.
Everything I owe you for the first backdrop, plus this one and even a little something extra just to counter because I'm gonna miss you so.
Miss Meadow.
Jack.
You're a gem.
Just tell me that you're going somewhere and you're not running away.
Does it matter?
When you go somewhere and it turns out not to be the right place, you can always go somewhere else. But if you're running away, nowhere's ever the right place.
Hey, how about letting a pal know you're alive?
Why don't I leave you?
Where you been? We couldn't find you.
Ever think I didn't want to be found?
Is that a real place? Is that Santa Fe?
Hey, have you seen the paper? We're front page news, above the fold. Oh yes, above the fold.
Good for you.
Everybody wants to meet the famous Jack Kelly. Even Spot Collins sent a kid just to say, next strike if you count on Brooklyn. How about that?
We got stomped into the ground.
They got us this time. I'll grant you that, but we took round one. With press like this, our fight is far from over.
Every newsie who could walk showed up this morning to sell papers like a strike never happened.
And I was out there with them. Jack, if I don't sell papers, my folks don't eat.
Save your breath, I get it. It's hopeless.
But then I saw this look on Weasel's face. He was actually nervous. And that's when I realized this isn't over. We got them scared, really scared. And so I walked away, and a lot of other kids did too, and that is what you call a beginning.
There is, just like I said.
Oh, for crying out loud, where's a fella gonna go to get away from you people?
There's no escaping us, pal, we're inevitable.
So what's the story? Can we have the theater?
Pat, I haven't asked yet.
What's the holdup? I gotta let my girl know we got a date.
Your girl?
You heard me. I've been swat skirts away all morning.
Jack's young man routine is getting tired. Even Horace Greeley moved back to New York.
Yes, he did. And then he died.
And reporters supposed to be nonpartisan?
Ask a reporter. Pulitzer's had me blacklisted from every news desk in town.
Can we table the Palava and get back to business? Will Meta let us have the theater?
It's what I've been trying to tell you. We want to hold a rally, a citywide meeting, where every newsie gets a say and a vote. And we do it after working hours, so nobody loses a day of pay. Smart?
Yeah, smart enough to get you committed to a padded room.
The guy who paints places he's never seen before is calling us crazy.
Oh, you want to see a place I see? How about this? Newsy Square takes to mind Big Mac, filled to overflowing with failure. Kids hurt, others are resting.
Lighten up. No one died.
Is that what you're aiming for? Go on, call me a coward. Call me a quitter. No way are you putting them kids back in danger.
Jack, we're doing something that has never been done before. How could that not be dangerous?
Specs put a note from Equestria at the refuge. I tried to see him find the fire escape, but they busted him up so bad, he couldn't even come to the window. What if you don't make it? Are you willing to shoulder that for a tenth of a penny a pay?
It's not about the pay. You said it yourself. My family wouldn't be in this mess if my father had a union. This is a fight we have to win.
If I wanted a sermon, I'd show up for church.
Tell me how quitting does cut you any good. Exactly. So here's how it goes. Once we win, and we will be winning, make no mistake.
We'll be what?
We're already winning.
Guys!
And we tell them straight out, they like crunchy gore, they keep getting pounded.
Dave, what the hell did they bust out your brain to something? As I recall, Dave, we all got our asses kicked, they won!
We won the battle.
Oh, come on!
If you think about it, we've got them surrounded.
Here's what I think, Joe's a jerk, he's a rattlesnake.
You're right, and you know why your snake starts to rattle.
Oh,
cause he's scared. Going looking up the poor guy's head is spinning. Why would he send for the goons? An entire army, dozens of goons, plus the cops and
you know you may be right.
Thank you God.
He wasn't afraid.
Exactly.
He knows we're winning. Get those kids to see we're circling victory. And watch what happens. We're doing something no one's even tried. And yes, we're terrified, but watch what happens.
You can't undo the bad,
so just move on
and stay on track. Cause Humpty Dumpty is about to crash.
We've got faith,
we've got the plan,
and we've got Jack.
So just watch what happens.
Newsies are striking against me.
Well, I'd spare you the embarrassment if I could, but the burlesque house is private property.
Oh, we can't order a raid without legal cause?
Mr. Mayor, would the fact that the rally is organized by an escaped convict be cause enough to shut it down?
An escaped convict?
A fugitive from one of your own institutions. A convicted thief at large wreaking mischief on our law-abiding community. Madam Schneider, which one is it?
That one. There. Jack Kelly.
And how do you know the boy?
This is not a pleasant story. He was first sentenced to my refuge for loitering and vagrancy, but his total disregard for authority has made him a frequent visitor.
Oh, but you called him a thief, an escaped convict.
After his release, I caught him myself red-handed trafficking stolen food and clothing. He was sentenced to 6 months, but the willful ruffian escaped.
So you'd be doing the city a service removing this criminal from our streets.
Well, if that truly is the case, I suppose we could take him quietly.
What good would quiet do me? I want a public example made of him.
Miss Pulitzer, the boy, Jack Kelly, is here.
Here?
Just outside, he's asked to see you.
Ask, and you shall be received. Madam Schneider, if you please. Sit. Charismatic union organizer, or the petty thief and escaped convict.
Oh, which one gives us more in common?
Impudence is in bad taste when crawling for mercy.
Crawling? Yeah, that's a laugh. I'm just stopped by with an invite. Seems a few hundred of your workers are rallying to discuss recent disagreements. I thought it only fair to invite you to state your case straight to the fellows. So what do you say, Joe? One, I should save you a spot in the bill.
You are as shameless and disrespectful a creature as I was told. Mm. Do you know what I was doing when I was your age, boy? I was fighting in a war.
Oh, yeah. How'd that work out for you?
It taught me a lesson that shaped my life. You don't win a war on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victor.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. When you all wakes up the front page photos of our rally.
Rally until the cows come home. Not a paper in town will publish your word. And if it's not in the paper, it never happened.
You may run the city, but there are some of us who can't be bullied. Even some reporters.
Such as that young woman who made you yesterday's news? Talented girl. And beautiful as well, don't you think?
Yeah, I'll tell you said so.
Maybe. She can hear for herself. Can't you, Darth? I trust you know my daughter, Catherine. Yes. My daughter. You're probably asking, well, why the nom de plume? Why doesn't my daughter work for me? Good questions. I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure. Instead, she chose to pursue a career and was showing real promise until this recent lapse. But you're done with all of that now, aren't you, sweetheart?
Jack.
Don't trouble the boy with your problems, dearest. Mr. Kelly has a plate full of his own. Wouldn't you say so, Madam Schneider?
Hello, Jack.
Does anyone else feel a noose tightening? But allow me to offer an alternate scenario. You attend the rally and speak against this hopeless strike, and I will see your criminal record expunged and your pockets filled with enough cash to carry you in a first-class train compartment from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say he wanted to travel west, didn't you?
There ain't a person in this room who don't know you stink.
And if they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my words, boy, defy me, and I will have you and every one of your friends locked up in the refuge. Oh, I know you're Mr. Tough Guy, but it's not right to subject that poor little crippled boy to conditions like that. And what about your pal Davy and his baby brother? Ripped from their loving family and tossed to the rats. Will they ever be able to thank you enough? Time's running out, Jack. So what do you say? Cowboy or convict, I win either way. Your abject surrender was always the bottom line. Gentlemen, escort our guest to the cellar so he can reflect in solitude. Too bad you've no job, Jack, but you did resign. Too bad you've no family, but you can't have mine. Be glad you're alive, boy, I'd say that's the bottom line.
And let the pipe bring you new one to play.
So those kids all believed he was right.
Lucky for them, all but one got away.
They may not
in case I've been polishing up my favorite brass knuckles.
You can sleep right here on this old print and press. That there is firm. Feed those boys. I don't understand. If you're willing to go to jail for these boys, how can you turn your back on them?
I don't think you're anyone to talk about turning on folks.
I never turned on you or anyone else.
No, you just double-crossed us to your father. Your father!
My father has eyes on every corner of the city. He doesn't need me spying for him. And I didn't lie. I just didn't tell you everything.
Well, if you want to go, you'll be trying to talk with a fist in your mouth.
I told you I worked for the Sun, and I did. I told you my professional name was Plumber, and it is. You never asked my real one.
I wouldn't think I had to unless I knew I was dealing with a backstabber.
If I were a boy, you'd be looking at me with one swollen eye.
Don't let that stop you. Give me a best shot.
I need to know you didn't cave for the money.
I spoke the truth. You were in a fight when you got the other fella down eating pavement. But you heard your father. No matter how many days we strike, you ain't giving up. I don't know what else we can do.
But I do. Really, Jack? Really? Only you can have a good idea? Or is it because I'm a girl?
Oh, hold on.
This would be a good time to shut up. Being boss doesn't mean you have all the answers. Just the brains to recognize the right one when you hear it.
I'm listening.
Good for you. So I was trying to push your idea. The rally was Davy's, and now mine's going to take us to the finish line. Deal with it.
The Children's Crusade?
For the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse, I beg you, join us. With these words, the strike stopped being just about the newsies. You challenged our whole generation to stand up and demand a place at the table.
The Children's Crusade?
Think, Jack, if we use my words with one of your drawings, and if every kid under 21 read it and stayed home from work, or better yet, a general citywide strike. Even my father couldn't ignore that.
Only one small problem. We got no way to print it.
Come on, there has to be one printing press my father doesn't control.
Oh, no.
What?
I know where there's a printing press no one would ever think would use.
Then why are we still standing here?
Wait, stop. What's this about for you? I don't mean the Children's Crusade. What's this about? Am I kidding myself? Or is there something?
Of course there is.
Well, don't just say it like it happens every day.
Oh, Jack.
I'm not an idiot. I know girls like you don't end up with guys like me. But standing here tonight looking at you, I'm scared tomorrow's gonna come and change everything. If there was a way I could grab a hold of something to make time stop, just so I could keep looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack Kelly, and I never saw it coming.
Was never meant to meet, and then we meet. Who knows why? One more stranger on the street, just someone sweet passing by. An angel come to save me, who didn't even know she gave me something to believe in, for even a day. One day, maybe forever. Thank you.
scared of you.
Don't be.
Not if I'm gone tomorrow.
Papa's ours still will be.
I have something to believe in. Now that I know you believed in me. I have something to believe in. Now that I know you.
Got enough keys here for the entire building. Has somebody been picking Daddy's pockets?
The janitor has been working here since he was 8 and hasn't had a raise in 20 years. He's with us 100%.
And you bring enough fellas to keep us coming?
I got enough guys to hold a hole down here, and nobody would be the wiser.
Good job.
It's good to have you back.
Shut up.
Here she is, boys, while my father snores blissfully in his bed. We'll be using one of his very own crests to bring him down.
Hey, she remind me to stay on the good side.
Is this where they print the papes on?
I see why they toss us over onto the cellar. Which will do the job?
Jack, this is Darcy, and he knows everything there is to know about printing.
You work for one of the pipes?
My father owns the trip.
Whoa. And this is Bill, and he will be typesetting the article for us.
Oh, Bill, so I suppose you're the son of William Randolph Hearst?
It's probably part of your revolution.
In the words of the little one, can we table the palaver and get back to business?
A little grease, and she's going to cold.
Alright, this is how it'll work. As we print the papers, Race, you let the rest of the fellas in, and they'll spread the papers to every working kid in New York. After that,
it's up to them.
There's change coming once and for all. You made the front page. And then you is major news. Tomorrow they'll see what we are. And sure as a star, we ain't come this far to lose.
Here they come.
This is the story we needed to write that's been kept out of sight for no more. In a few hours, by dawn's early light, we'll be ready to fight us a war. This time we're in it to stay. Talk about seizing the day.
Write it in ink or in blood, it's the same either way. They're gonna damn well pay.
The bullets are snug in his bed, he don't care if we're dead or alive. Three satin pillows are under his head while he's begging for bread to survive. So you can stop counting sheep. We're gonna sing you asleep. Then while you snooze, we'll be lighting a fuse with a promise we ain't gonna keep. Once and for all, if they don't mind our manners, we'll bleed 'em.
Bleed 'em.
Once and for all, we won't carry no banners that don't
spell freedom. Finally raising the stakes. This time, whatever it takes. This time the union awaits, once and for all.
In the words of union leader Jack Kelly, we will work with you, we will even work for you, but we will be paid and treated as valuable members of your organizations. Riveting stuff, huh?
Get going, you've got a very important man to see.
Keep your fingers crossed.
Rush to.
Okay, come on, fellas.
Correct.
This is for kids shiny shoes on the street with no shoes on their feet every day. This is for guys sweating blood in the shops while their bosses and cops look away. I'm seeing kids getting tall.
I'm sorry, I'm
Silence
sorry.
Silence those phones!
The whole city is at a standstill. No one is working anywhere, and everyone is blaming you.
Everybody is calling. The mayor, the manufacturers, the publishers, oi!
How are we doing this morning, gents?
But you can't just barge in. You can't just barge in.
More behind this. We had a deal.
Oh, and it came with a money back guarantee. Thanks for your lessons on the power of the press.
Did you read this, boss? These kids put out a pretty good paper. It's very convincing.
No doubt written by my daughter.
Oh, yeah, I'd sign her before someone else snatches her up.
I demand to know who defied my ban on printing strike material.
Well, your loyal employees, we'd never take our business elsewhere.
The old printing press in the cellar.
I leave you the offer of a lifetime. Anyone who does not act in his own self-interest is a fool.
Then what does that make you? This all started because you wanted to sell more papes, and now your circulation is down 70%. Why didn't you just come talk to us?
Well, guys like Joe won't talk to nothings like us. But a very wise reporter told me, a real boss don't need the answers. Just a smash to snatch the right one when he hears it. Is closed to business, paralyzed. You can't get a paper or a shoe shine or cross the Brooklyn Bridge, send a message. You can't even leave your own building. So what's your next move?
Mr. Pulitzer, the mayor is here along with your daughter and oh, you'll never believe who else.
Good morning, Mr. Pulitzer. I believe you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt? Joseph, Joseph, Joseph. What have you done now?
I'm certain once you hear my explanation of
thanks to Miss Meadowlark and bring your daughter to my office, I already have a thorough grasp of the situation. Graphic illustrations included. Bully is a term I usually employ to show approval, but in your case, I simply mean bully. Is this the boy of whom you spoke? How are you, son?
Pleasure's mine, Mr. Governor.
I'm told we once shared a carriage ride. Well, Joe, Joe, just don't stand there letting those children sing endlessly. Give them the good news.
What good news?
That you've come to your senses and rolled back prices. Unless, of course, you want to invite a full state Senate investigation into your employment practices.
You wouldn't dare.
After the pressure you wielded to keep me from office, I'd do it with a smile. Come along, Joseph. There's only one thing worse than a hard heart, and that's a soft head. And think of the happiness you'll bring those children. He doesn't do happy, does he?
Mr. Kelly, if I may speak with you, alone.
Your eyes on the stars and your feet on the ground. You can do this.
I can't put the price back where it was. I'm sorry. I can't. There are other considerations.
I get it. You gotta save face on all these folks. I'm young. I ain't stupid.
Thank you for understanding.
But I got constituents with a legitimate gripe.
What if I reduce the raise by half and get the others to do the same? It's a compromise we can all live with.
But you eat our losses. From now on, any papes we can't sell, you buy back, full price.
That was never on the table. What's to stop the newsies from taking hundreds of papers they can't sell? My cost would explode.
Oh, No news, he's gonna break his back hauling tapes he can't sell. But if he can take a few more with no risk, he might sell them and your circulation will begin to grow. It's a compromise we can all live with.
It's not a bad head you have on your shoulders.
Deal?
That's disgusting.
That's just business.
And the world will know.
Young man's artistry shine a lantern behind your closed doors?
Yeah, don't sweat it, Gov. With the strike settled, I probably should be hitting the road.
Don't you ever get tired of singing the same old tune? I mean, what's Santa Fe got? The New York game? Sandstorms?
And better yet, what's New York got that Santa Fe ain't?
Well, New York's got us, and we're family.
Did I hear something about the strike being settled?
Thanks, Mother Newsies! Line up!
Come along, Governor, and show me the back seat I've been hearing so much about. Don't just stand there. You've got a union to run. And besides, did someone offer you a pretty exciting job?
Me? Work for your father?
You already work for my father.
Oh, yeah.
And you've got one more ace up your sleeve.
What would that be?
Me? Wherever you go, I'll be there right by your side.
For sure.
For sure.
Don't take much to be a dreamer. All you do is close your eyes. So many top world is all you ever see. Now my eyes is finally open, and my dreams they average size, but they don't much matter.